हेलो एवरी वन, वेलकम बैक इन टूडेज क्लास. स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव डिस्कस द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ चैप्टर 12 इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो, दैट इज हीरोन्स फॉर्मूला. टुडे वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग अवर एक्सरसाइज 12.1. ओके, लेट अस सी व्हाट क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 सेज. अ ट्रैफिक सिग्नल बोर्ड इंडिकेटिंग स्कूल अहेड इज एन इक्विलेटरल ट्रायंगल. दैट मीन्स वी हैव आर ट्रैफिक सिग्नल इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एन इक्विलेटरल ट्रायंगल. ओके, इट इज रिटन ऑन इट स्कूल अहेड. School ahead. Okay, this is an equilateral triangle with sides A. All sides are same. In case of equilateral triangle, A, B, and C, all sides are same. Find the area of the signal board. We have to find the area of this triangle. That means here we have this signal board using Heron's formula. Okay, they have mentioned here that we will use the formula of Heron's here. If its perimeter is okay, what is given? Given information is perimeter of the triangle is given. Perimeter of the triangle is 180 centimeter. They are asking what is the area of the signal board. Area of signal board, or if we will take, this is an equilateral triangle. This is what we have to find out in this question. Okay. Dear students, just to see, perimeter is given. This is the most important information they have given to us. This is the perimeter, and perimeter says sum of all sides. That means A plus A plus A, all sides, the sum of all sides is 180. That means 3A is equal to 180 degree. That means all side will be of 60 centimeter each. Okay, that means this is also 60, same, and this will also be of 60 centimeter. Okay, we go to the sides. Now we have to use Heron's formula. Heron's formula says first we have to find semi perimeter. Okay, semi perimeter, that is S equals to A plus A plus A divided by 2. That means A plus A, 180 divided by 2, this will be of 90 centimeter. Now we have to apply area of triangle, area of equilateral triangle. What is the area? S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. What is our S here? We got it as 90. 90 minus 60, we will get 30. Again 90 minus 60, because all sides are same. A is also 30, B is also 30, C is also 30. That means all side will remain same. It will be 30. 30 each, we will divide it. Now see, how can I divide 90? See the student, this is important. How can I divide 2 multiply by 3 multiply by 3 multiply by 5? 2, 3 is 6, 6, 3 is 18, 18, 5 is 90. Okay, 90, I have broken it down. Now 30, 2 multiply by 3 multiply by 5, 2, 3 is 6, 6, 5 is 30. Same way this 30, 2 into 3 into 5. Same way this 30, 2 into 3 into 5. Fine, this is what we have discussed in our previous video, that how can we break them down. Now next step, we have to see our pairs. 1, this 2, then 2 will come. Okay, 3 and 3, 3 will come. This 5 and 5, 5 will come from here. 3 and this 3, 3 will come here. This 2 and 2, 2 will come here. 5 and 5, 5 will come. What is remain inside? 3 will remain inside, because this 3 doesn't have any pair, so it will remain inside under the root. Multiply 2, 3 is 6, 6, 5 is 30, 33 is 90, 92 is 180, 185 is 900. 900 root 3 centimeter square. This is the area of the required triangle. Okay, in this question, students, they have given that it was an equilateral triangle and we have to find its perimeter by Heron's formula. That's why we have applied. Otherwise, we have a short formula for finding area of an equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle. The area says, this is another method, okay? If you cannot go for this, why? Because they have very clearly, they have mentioned that we have to use Heron's formula. But there is a short formula, root 3 by 4 multiply by a square. Here this a is our side. Root 3 divided by 4 multiply, side is 30. Square of 30 means 30 into 30. You can cut, it will be cut on 2, and here it 15, it will be go for 15. Sorry, it is 60. I'm so sorry. The side of the equilateral triangle is 60. So by 40, it will go with 15. It will remain 60. That means it will remain like root 3 multiply by 15 multiply by 60. When will you multiply 60 and 50? You will get 900, and this root 3 will remain same. 900 centimeter square. The same area we got by Heron's formula. There will not be any change in the area if we are using the different methods. Okay, here this is area of equilateral triangle, but they asked us to use Heron's formula, so we have used. Area will remain same by both the methods. I hope the question is clear for everyone. Let us see our question number 2. This is the figure given in question number 2. We have a flyover. On a flyover, there are two sides. This side is used for advertisement purpose. And if I see this figure carefully, I can see it is a right angle triangle. I cannot say it is a right angle triangle, but all sides are different. So I will be using Heron's formula for finding the area. The question says the triangular side walls of the flyover has been used for advertisement. Okay, the sides of the walls are 120, 20, 2 and 120 meter. Okay, they all are in meter. These are the sides given. The advertisement yields an earning of rupees 5000 per meter square per year. A company hired one of its wall for 3 months. That means this area is taken for advertisement. This area is being hired by a company for the advertisement only for 3 months. How much rent do they pay? Unko kitna rent dena padega? Okay. रेंट तो तब पता लगेगा जब तक हमें एरिया नहीं पता होगा. वी कैनॉट फाइंड द रेंट कि हम कितना निकालेंगे. सो फॉर दैट वी विल बी यूजिंग हीरोन्स फॉर्मूला. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 2, साइड्स ऑफ ट्राइंगल 122 मीटर कोमा 22 मीटर कोमा 120 मीटर. फर्स्ट वी विल बी फाइंडिंग एस मीन्स 122 प्लस 22 प्लस 120 डिवाइड बाय 2. When you will add all these, what will you get? Just add, you will get 364. What will you get? You will get 264. I will get 264 divided by 2. When I will cut it, I will get 132. This is what my S. Now find area of the triangle. Area of given triangle, that is S. What is S? 132. Directly I'm writing. Then 132 minus first side. 132 minus first side. 132 minus second side. And 132 minus my third side. Okay. Then start doing calculation. 132 minus 120 I will get 10. 132 minus 22 I will get 110. And 132 minus 120 I will get 12. That means 132, 10, 110 and 12. Now start breaking it down. 132, do it by prime factorization. If you cannot do the direct calculation, see 132, how can I break it down? 2, it will be 66. 2, then it will be 33. 3, then it will be 11. Okay, then how can I write it as 2 into 2 into 3 into 11? Student, how can I write 10? Can I write 2 5s? It was very easy. 110, same way you can use 110. 2, 55, 2, 5, 11. That means 2 into 5 into 11. How can I write 12? 2 multiply by 3. 2, 3 is 6. 6, 2 is 12. Okay, same method. Pairs we can take out of this 2. One pair, this 3 and this 3. Another pair, okay. Likewise, I will be finding the pairs from these 2. 2 will come outside. 3 and 3. 3 will come. 11 and 11. Okay, pair was there. 11. This 2 and 2. 2 will come. 5, 5. 5 will come. This 2 and 2. 2 will come outside. Fine. These are the number which will come outside. Now, 2, 3 is 6. 6, 2 is 12. 12, 2 is 24. 24, 5 is 24 5 what I will get? I will get 120. And 120 multiply by 11, student, what I will get? 1320. This I will get. That means this is the area of the triangle. And student, this question is not completed by this by finding the area of the triangle. Hame uska rent dena hai. Or see, first of all, this is my area. जो मेरा 1 मंथ का, जो मेरा 3 मंथ्स का एरिया आएगा, जो मेरा सॉरी 3 मंथ्स का जो मेरा रेंट आएगा, मेरे को इसके साथ मल्टीप्लाई करना है, क्योंकि हम एरिया को मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे तो रेंट निकलेगा ना हमारे पास. फाइन, जो एडवर्टीजमेंट पर्सन है उन्होंने 1 ईयर का 5,000 रुपीज़ लिया है, बट हमें जो ये वॉल थी वो हमने 1 ईयर के लिए नहीं लिया, हमने 3 मंथ्स के लिए लिया है. पहले हम 1 मंथ का निकालेंगे तभी हम 3 मंथ्स का निकाल पाएंगे. अगर हम 1 मंथ का रेंट निकालेंगे दैट मीन्स 5,000 डिवाइड बाई 12, और हमें निकालना कितना है, वी हैव टू फाइंड फॉर 3 मंथ्स, क्योंकि हमने सिर्फ 3 मंथ्स के लिए इस वॉल को हायर किया है. दैट मीन्स 5,000 डिवाइड बाई 12 मल्टीप्लाई बाई 3. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर, बिकॉज दिस मैथड इज फ्रॉम वेयर आई एम यूजिंग, दिस इज स्मॉलर क्लास मैथड 4. और जब आप इसको कट करेंगे तो वट आंसर यू विल गेट 1,250. दिस इज़ वट यू विल गेट. मतलब अगर आप अपना खर्चा निकाले तो 1 मीटर का आपका कॉस्ट कितना आता है, 1 मीटर अगर आपका एरिया तो 1,250, बट आपका एरिया कितना है 1,320, तो टोटल रेंट पेड कितना हो जाएगा, टोटल रेंट पेड दैट इज टोटल एरिया, हमारा जो एरिया था मल्टीप्लाई बाय रेंट पर मीटर स्क्वायर. ओके, तो अभी आप क्या करेंगे, यहाँ पे टोटल रेंट कितना था 1,320, और 1 मीटर का कितना, 1 मीटर स्क्वायर का रेंट कितना देना पड़ेगा हमें 1,250. स्टूडेंट मल्टीप्लाई, यू विल गेट 1,650,000 रुपीज़. इतना आपको रेंट देना पड़ेगा अगर आपको इस ट्रायंगल को हायर करना है एडवर्टीजमेंट के लिए. ओके, आई होप द क्वेश्चन इज क्लियर फॉर एवरीवन. Okay students, we will be doing only 2 questions from this exercise. Remaining question we will do in our next class, in our next video. Okay, if you really liked my video, if you really find it important and useful for you, please do not forget to subscribe my channel. Like it also, press like button. Okay, then we will meet in our next class. Till then, goodbye and take care of yourself.